fight to get here has defeated William Borland with an average of 105, a 6-4 success for Diamond White there. He then beats
99
Brazil's Diogo Portela in a match that we streamed live here on Stream 1. Portela stuck with him for much of it, but White just
135
flicked on the afterburners towards the back end of the match, and that was his lowest average of the day, 102.4. He smashed that out of the park in his next win against John Henderson, 6-3, and an average of 111.3 before an average of 103.7 in a 6-2 win against Stephen Bunting. As the day is going on, it seems to be getting more convincing from Ian White.
180.
The story of Dave Chisnall's day is that he can't stop hitting 180s. That is the 17th of the afternoon for him, and he's averaging
104.
A tally of hitting one every other leg so far today. Chisnall began this afternoon by beating Adam Huckvale 6-2.
41.
He then topped the ton mark in terms of his three-dart average when he beat Darren Penhall 6-3 before knocking out Mervyn King 6-5 on the King's birthday. Before
45.
Whitewashing Christian Bunzer 6-0 in the last 16. That slip from Ian White means he's on a bogey, and Chisnall has a bit of breathing space here. They could look at the ball.
60.
That's what he was attempting. Because had he found the 25, it'd be on a slightly simpler shot. 80 would mean no danger of having to go for the ball at the end of the combination, which is very much a danger now.
127.
And there is the warning from White. Doesn't have to bother with a bullseye now because he's perfectly found the treble, and he can just try and clip that in off the barrel and into the bed, but it's just diverted beneath, and Ian White survives an early scare. Double eight.
16.
Well, three darts missed at double to hold, and Dave Chisnall will be thinking it's his birthday.
Game shot.
A gift in the end, having given White an opportunity that he failed to take. Does have the better of the head-to-head record between the pair, does Dave Chisnall. Has won 11 of their 18 previous meetings. The most recent, actually back in 2018. And the pair met at the European Darts Grand Prix in the last 16 stage, and Chizzy averaged 107 and won 106.5, despite averaging 12 points more than Ian White. He only did it in the last leg decider.
58.
Surprising, perhaps, that it is the first meeting for the best part of a couple of years, but they will be well versed in the successes of one another. Now, will we see any success here as Ian White threatens a perfect leg, having lost the first two? White has kicked off the third with back-to-back maximums. He's even got time to hand
60
Dave Chisnall one of his darts. Now he zones in and homes in on the treble 20. Couldn't find it. Would have been a golden nugget of a leg from the diamond.
95.
A reminder, Kim Hybrecht's waiting the winner of this one.
99.
In the semi-finals, and then James Wade 1-0 up against Keegan Brown. Dirk Telnick has 1-0 up against Luke Woodhouse, the winners of those matches, to go head-to-head.
Game shot.
As Ian White completes an 11-darter. And a break and throw. to boot, and that was probably much needed. Second successive leg. White begins perfectly.
140.
Chisnall, who has racked up almost twice the amount of maximums that Ian has this afternoon, fails to follow suit, and we will not get the prospect of a perfect leg this time around. But a maximum here would level the scores. Creeping in for Dave Chisnall there, who has ditched the specs, you may have noticed. Ditched them when he was 7-1 down against Willie O'Connor mid-match in Minehead at the UK Open, and he roared back and only lost that match 10-8 in the end. Really was struggling with the glasses, Dave Chisnall. He's having to consider alternative options.
100.
Hey. Put another one there to leave himself on 32.
39.
An opportunity that he probably shouldn't have had. Two twenties. Very, very similar marker to the one that he missed earlier, but this time he uses it effectively and restores that two-leg cushion that he carved out. Breaking at the first available opportunity.
96.
White is at it again. It's the third straight leg that he's started with the maximum.
180.
This time Chisnall responds in kind, but he would be powerless to stop White winning the leg if he remains perfect. He's at it again. He's on it again. Legs ago, Ian White's run of perfect darts ended after six. And it happens again. White on a nine darter in this leg. Now Chisnall was looking
98,
taking out the biggest finish of them all to steal it in an artful dodger act. Instead, White eyes up tops. Just has had a bit of trouble at the end of legs here, Ian White.
Game
but he puts that right and breaks back. Twice now Ian White has been broken and then responded with an 11 darter. Strange one, because Ian White will be wondering how he's behind in this match, considering he's averaging 100 after
58
five legs. But Dave Chisnall has had opportunities, albeit outside ones, but he has had opportunities to be even further ahead.
140.
White's been averaging over the last four players' championship events over 105. That is some standard. A standard that any player in the world would be proud of, and
140.
Take your arm off for. you offered it them. You tell Michael Van Gerwen you're going to average 105 for the rest of the season. I think he'd hedge his bets and say I'll win plenty with that. Certainly is leading the way in terms of setting the standard, and it would be perhaps fitting for him to pick up a title sooner rather than later.
121.
Well, he stayed on the treble 20 there. He might have been wiser to go for the bullseye. Leave himself a slightly easier outshot. And he is outshot by Dave Chisnall, who tees up tops, and White has to be perfect, and more often than not in this match. He's missed when he's had one dart. Chooses double 11.
Game
does
shot.
Not miss this time. An excellent choice here. Now is Chizzy going to tee up the prospect of perfection?
140.
Not to be. He'll just be relieved to see that Ian White's not doing it. Again to throw this time around.
43.
But his scores from the other quarterfinals currently in play. Dirk Telnicker's 3-2 ahead against Luke Woodhouse, James Wade. Leads Keegan Brown by the same scoreline. As I mentioned, Kim Heibrecht's already through. One worry for Ian White is that he is finding ways to lose matches when he's producing such a sublime standard, often a superior standard to his opponents. Beaten at this stage by James Wade yesterday in the last leg decider, despite averaging 107, thanks to a 161 checkout from the machine in that final leg. Another 180 from Ian White, who before this match had hit six all day, and now he's hit the same amount. Seven legs. Double 18 then for Chisnall. So just keep his nose in front and just keep Ian White at bay. At it again, Ian White.
180.
Seven maximums in this match against one of the biggest 180 hitters in the game, getting a dose of his own medicine. Has hit three himself. Means we're running currently at 10 maximums in this match.
90.
Just eight legs. If White misses this, it's time for another. But he hasn't missed it. It is a third 11 darter in this match for Ian White, who once again restores parity. Very clean kill of that 81. And that will be encouraging for Diamond White, because he had one slight chink in the armour in the early exchanges in this match, and that was struggling to nail doubles with the first dart. Now it's all coming together.
140.
The winner of this match will be over on stream 2 in the semi-final, taking on Kim Hybrex. It will be make your mind up time for which semi-final you want to watch before the final. Back here
58
on stream 1. James Wade 4-3 up against Keegan Brown. He will take on the winner of Dirk Telmekers against Luke Woodhouse if he gets past Brown. Telmekers closing in on a first PDC semi-final, 5-2 up against Woodhouse. What a weekend for him, having seen off Peter Wright and Gary Anderson yesterday. He now finds himself on the brink of a place in the semi-final.
140.
White on the brink of a break here.
100.
Treble 18 will be the first port of call. Now a fat 20. And a double top.
Game shot.
To put White in front. For the first time in the match. Remarkable considering that he's been averaging around 108 for the majority of it. That's where he is now, and he's piled in 7 maximums.
100.
All about the 108 and the 180s for Ian White. Chisnall ending the mini drought of maxes in this match, taking us to 11 and his own tally to 4. Would be ironic, wouldn't it, if Ian White, having been on the 9 data twice in this tie,
174,
were to have one hit against him. Might happen. Not in this leg though. Chisnall disappointed. I think both players feel that something like that should happen in this match. Meanwhile, Ian White's just under the radar, landed a 174.
100.
And the 2 tons either side of it have put him in a handy position to win the match here and now. For the ball to win it in style, and it is 127, and what a game.